Once upon a time, in the suburban neighborhood of a deep, dark forest, lived a deer family, Buck Whitetail.
Hey, how's it going there, buddy?
His wife, Dolene.
Charmed, I'm sure.
And their two teenagers, Spike.
Hello?
And his big sister, Bambi.
Whatever.
It was a typical Friday at Deep Dark Forest Estates as Buck arrived home after a long, hard week.
Dolene, I'm home.
How was your day, dear? Why? What's wrong, dear?
Oh, I don't know, dear. I guess I've been in a rut lately. Plus, I made the mistake of taking the interstate home.
Oh, dear. You know I don't like you crossing that thing.
I thought I could handle it, but then this guy pulls up and he's got his high beams on, right? And I don't know. I can't explain it, but I was mesmerized. Those lights, those beautiful lights. I couldn't take my eyes off of them.
Oh, stop it, stop it. You're scaring me.
I know, Biggie, huh? He flashed his light, so I gave him a little head fake, and he bit, so he never touched me.
Well, wash up for supper. I made your favorite, apple crisp with maple leaves, and it's almost ready.
And so Buck called the kids to supper.
Spike, Bambi, supper's ready. Come on, let's go. Let's whitetail it out here.
And in ran Spike.
Oh, boy. Apple crisp.
Now. Did you wash your hooves?
Yes, ma'am.
So what did you kids have planned for tonight?
Oh, we're going to the big game. It's going to be a blast.
Wait. Big game? Blast? I don't like the sound of that.
Your father's right. I don't want to hear that kind of language, young buck. Now, who all is going?
Just the guys. You know, me, Fluffy, Stinky, and Jerry Mathers is the beaver.
I see.
Then she whispered to her husband.
Buck, I'm worried about the beaver.
Nah, he's all right. I worked with his father last year on that river project. Sharp guy. I'm more worried about Stinky. Isn't he that little squirt with the racing stripes?
Yes, but he's harmless.
Well, as long as he doesn't start rubbing off on Spike.
Spike, honey, where's your sister?
And just then, in waltzed the little princess, Bambi.
I'm like, here, okay?
Oh, don't you look pretty. And your spots are clearing up nicely, too.
Mother, thank you for, like, noticing in front of the whole free world.
Yeah, Bambi, looks like the deer still is working.
Yeah, like maybe you should try it too, okay?
I don't need to because I don't have a boyfriend.
Well, that's encouraging.
Bambi's got a boyfriend. Bambi's got a boyfriend.
Like, be quiet, okay?
She likes Walter.
Walter? Isn't he one of those coyotes?
As if. Like, I'd fall for some geeky coyote, I'm so sure.
Yeah, he's not a coyote. Walter's a... He's a wolf.
Gasp.
It was true. Walter was indeed a wolf.
Oh, please. Walter is very sweet. He's taking me to the prance. Yeah, and then we're going out for a bite with the rest of his pack.
Wait. Pack of wolves out for a bite? I don't like the sound of that. In fact, I forbid you to see him.
Oh, Daddy.
And with that, Bambi leapt to her room in tears, while her dad and brother settled into their lazy deers to watch some TV.
Let's see what's on here. Reruns of Hunter?
Nah.
Oh, here we go. NBA basketball.
Minnesota, Milwaukee, yay! The Bucks against the Timberwolves.
Yeah, you gotta love the irony, huh? But wouldn't you know, it's halftime, so let's go check on your sister.
Meanwhile, back in Bambi's room.
Bambi?
Mother? Mother?
Listen, dear, it's not that we don't want you to be happy. We just don't want you to get hurt. Or devoured.
Your mother's right. There are plenty of fish in the sea.
But, Daddy, we're forest creatures. Hello?
Yeah, Dad, that was lame.
Oh, okay, bad analogy. The point is, your old buck loves you, honey, and, well, you don't get a wreck like this growing out of your head without having a few brains attached.
Ew, Daddy.
You're losing her, Pop.
Oh, what I mean is, he's a wolf. He's going to break your heart, and then he's going to eat it.
What your father's trying to say is, Walter's a wolf. A carnivore, a meat eater, and you're a doe, a deer.
A female deer.
Okay, you've like made your 8 points. But now I'm gonna like have to go to the prance all by myself.
Oh, you mean stag?
Daddy!
Don't worry, I hear Moose thinks you're kind of cool.
Moose? Ooh, really?
Hey, he's the captain of the team, isn't he?
Yeah, of course, he can't get his head through the door.
Oh, is he rather stuck on himself?
No, he really can't get his head through the door. He's a moose, for Pete's sakes.
Oh.
And so Buck and Dolene settled back for a quiet night of TV.
Oh, look, Survivor's on.
Wimps.
Spike went to the game with his buddies.
Ew, Stinky. Good one, dude.
And the fickle Bambi has found someone new to fawn after.
The